नव इन प्रेजेंट लेक्चर वील डिस्कस दिस सेकंड वन आर्टिकल हे दूसरा आर्टिकल कंटिन्यू करूया हेडिंग ऑफ आर्टिकल हेट इज सम स्पेशल इंटीग्रल्स नाउ फॉर युअर सिलेबस देर आर सिक्स स्पेशल इंटीग्रल्स दीज थ्री इंटीग्रल्स इन विच इंटीग्रैंड इज विदाउट स्क्वेयर रूट एंड इन दीज थ्री इंटीग्रल्स इंटीग्रैंड इज विथ स्क्वेयर रूट नाउ हियर इट इज वेन इंटीग्रेशन इज 1 upon x square plus a square dx, then answer we have to write like this, 1 upon a tan inverse of x by a plus c. Whatever we are having, such type of format, then we write answer in this format. When problem is of this second format, then answer we have to write in this way. Here it is x square plus a square. In this one, x means variable term, a means constant term. Here a means constant term, x means variable term. This is x square plus a square, it is a reverse, a square minus x square, but all integrands are in. Without square root form, when it is a plus sign, answer is in 1 by a form. When integrand is with minus sign, answer is 1 upon 2a. Now concerning to this one, here all integrands are with square root. Now in this one, coefficient of x square is positive. Here coefficient of x square is positive. X square coefficient is positive, x square coefficient is positive. We have to write the answer as log of x plus square root and plus c, log of x plus square root and plus c. When integrand contains a square root with x square coefficient is negative, then answer is in the form of 1 upon a sine inverse x upon a, means x square coefficient is positive, answer is in log. X square coefficient is positive, answer is in log. X square coefficient is negative, answer is in sine inverse. You have to remember such type of formula here without square root, 1 upon a, 1 upon 2a format, and if it is with square root, then answer is in log tone. Or it is 1 upon a sine inverse of x by a. Now we will make practice on these special integrals here now. Now we will take problems on these special integrals. Now here, very first. Now every problem is of evaluate. Suppose this problem is given. Integration of 1 upon x square plus 9 and then that dx. Let this problem as capital I. It is 1 upon x square plus 9 and then that dx. Here it is x square and plus 9 means 3 square and then that dx. We will write answer like this. 1 upon 3 tan inverse of x upon 3 and plus c. Why it is written? Because answer you are written because format is 1 upon x square plus a square dx. What is the answer by your original formula? It is 1 upon a tan inverse of x upon a plus c, and that's why we have written this one answer of very first problem. Suppose this second problem is given. In this one, if it is written like this, it is a 4x square plus 25 and then dx. It is 1 upon 4x square plus 25 dx. In same way, we will write like this, 1 upon, this is a perfect square of 2x, and it is a perfect square of 5 and then that dx. Before writing the answer, this theorem, it is studied in 11th also and 12th also. If x coefficient of x is 2, it is your prime duty to write 1 by 2 outside first and then formula. Now when plus sign is there, your answer tone is 1 upon a tan inverse of x upon a. It is 1 upon a, a means 5. It is a tan inverse of x upon a means 2x upon 5 and plus c. So what should be your final answer? 1 by 10 tan inverse of 2x by 5 and plus c. Now third one problem. Integration of 1 upon 5x square plus 7 and then dx. Right here, let capital I equal to integration of 1 upon 5x square plus 7 dx. We will solve maximum problems from the special integral list now, in current lecture that is. So it is integration 1 upon, it is a root 5x bracket square plus a root 7 bracket square. Once again, that basic theorem we have to use here, coefficient of x is root 5. So firstly, we have to write 1 upon root 5 and then go through that list of 6 special integrals. Here sign is plus, so your answer is in the tone 1 upon a. A means root 7 and here it is a tan inverse of variable term numerator la. It is root 5x upon constant term denominator and plus c. So 5 7s are 35, 1 upon root 35. It is a tan inverse of root 5x upon root 7 and then lastly it is plus c. It is your final answer, third one. Now coming to fourth question, that is integration of 1 upon 4x square minus 1. 1 upon 4x square minus 1 and then dx. So we will continue. It is 1 upon, I think it is 2x whole square. This is 1 square and then dx. Before writing answer, it is 1 by 2. Before writing answer, it is 1 by 2. I think this sign is here minus. So your formula is 1 upon 2a, a into log of and plus c. Here is 2x. You have to write 2x 1. Here 2x 1. Here format is 1 upon 2a. A means constant term. Constant term is here 1. Now this equation or this expression is start with variable. So minus numerator la plus denominator la. What should be answer here? 1 by 4. It is a log of 2x minus 1 upon 2x plus 1 and then plus c. It is your required answer. Now take fifth one problem. Integration of 1 upon square root of 3x square plus 8. 3x square plus 8 and then dx. We write like this, it is 1 upon root of, it is a perfect square of root 3x and plus, it is a perfect square of root 8 and in that dx. So it is a perfect square of root 3x and plus 2 root 2 bracket square and in dx. This problem is with square root or without square root? This problem is with square root. So answer is in log formation. So your answer is log, here plus, here square root and plus c. It is your final answer. Here we have to write variable term. Which term is variable term? It is root 3x. But before that, root 3x is printed, means we have to write very first. It is 1 upon root 3 and it is a log of root 3x. And here it is root 3x bracket square plus 2 root 2 bracket square. Means answer is 1 by root 3 is a log of root 3x plus root of 3x square plus 8 modulus close and plus c. It is your fifth problem. Now coming to sixth one. Maximum problems we will cover in this present lecture. Here it is sixth one. It is 1 upon square root of 9 minus 25 x square and in that dx. It is equal to 1 upon square root of 9 means it is a perfect square of 3 and 25x is a perfect square of 5x and in dx. Before writing answer, I think here coefficient of x is 5, so it is a prime duty to write 1 by 5. After that, this problem is with square root. Problem is with square root means answer is in log or sin inverse. Here coefficient of x square is negative, so answer is 1 upon a sin inverse of variable term upon constant plus c. Here it is 1 upon a means this constant term 3, variable term is 5x, constant term is 3. So what is the answer? 1 upon 15 sin inverse of 5x upon 3 and then plus c. Problem completes here only. These problems are very easy and very straightforward. Suppose if we take that seventh one problem, it is integration of 1 upon square root of 3x square minus 5 and then dx. So we will write this as 1 upon square root of root 3x bracket square minus root 5 bracket square and in that tx before writing answer. Now here x coefficient is root 3, so it is prime duty to write here 1 by root 3. Now this problem is with root, so answer is either log or sine inverse. Here x square coefficient is positive, so answer is in log of plus square root and plus c. Problem stops here only, just wait, right here variable term. Variable term is root 3x, and that square root is as it is, root 3x square plus root 5 square. Your last step is like this, 1 by root 3 is a log of root 3x plus root of 3x square plus 5, and in that plus c. Now somewhat changes here. Question number 8. It is integration of 1 upon. These are again simple and very best problems. Those who are having command on quadratic 10th standard, the Abhisha quadratic or Jana command, they can solve this problem very easily. It is equal to 1 upon. Here it is x square plus 8x. Which term is added, which term is subtracted, and plus 20 in order to get a p of x square. I think you are knowing. Here coefficient of x is 8, duty is multiplied by 1 by 2 and then square. 2 4s are 8, 4 square it is 16, so add 16, subtract 16, it is a perfect square, and this remaining now, it is 1 upon, it is a perfect square of x plus 4, and this is a plus 4, then that dx. Just continue. Just proceed here. It is equal to, it is 1 upon x plus 4 bracket square plus 2 square. After that, this problem is with square root or without square root. I think this problem is without square root, means answer is either in 1 upon a tan inverse form or 1 upon 2a log form. Here it is a plus, so the answer is 1 upon a tan inverse of variable term upon constant term and plus c. So you have to write here 1 by 2. Here term is x plus 4, denominator is 2, it is your final answer. Now coming to that 9th problem, 8th problem it is completed. Now we will take that 9th one problem. It is integration of 1 upon 9x square plus 6x plus 10 and in that dx. It is equal to integration of 1 upon. It is your prime duty to take common actually here. Here is coefficient of x square is 9, but we have to take 9 common, and we get here x square plus 6 by 9x plus 10 by 9 and in that dx. 1 upon 9 is constant, take outside, integration of 1 upon x square plus 3. 2s are 3, 3s are, that is 2 by 3x plus 10 by 9 and in that dx. Now adjustment is like this, this is a 2 by 3 coefficient of x, multiply it compulsory by 1 by 2 and bracket square means 1 by 9. So which term is added and which term is subtracted? So add 1 by 9, subtract 1 by 9. So continue here, it is 1 upon 9, integration 1 upon x square plus 2 by 3x plus, add 1 by 9, subtract 1 by 9, plus 10 by 9 and in that dx. Now these three terms and these three terms, what are the terms after simplification? Here it is 1 upon, it is a perfect square of x plus 1 by 3, this is 10 minus 1 means 9, it is 9 by 9 and in that dx. So it is 1 upon 9 integration, that 9 and 9 get cancelled, so it becomes x plus 1 by 3 bracket square plus 1. It is having straight formula of tan inverse 1 by 9. This formula is of tan inverse of x plus 1 by 3 plus c. I think it is very straight problem, because here is plus 1, here plus 1 is there, that's why it is x square plus 1 tan inverse of variable term plus c. It is your final answer. Question number 9, it is completed. Now take 10th one question. In present lecture, we will solve various problems on this one. Question number 10. It is integration of 1 upon x square plus 4x minus 5 and in that dx. So it is 1 upon x square plus 4x, add, subtract and minus 5 and in that dx. It is your duty. Here it is, coefficient is 4 multiplied by 1 by 2 bracket square. 2 2's are 4, it is a 2 square, it is equal to 4. So which term is added, which term is subtracted in this present problem? Add 4, subtract 4, these 3 terms and these 2 terms. Here it is integration of 1 upon x plus 2 bracket square minus 9 and in that dx. I want perfect squaring. 1 upon x plus 2 whole square minus 3 square and in that dx. Now in this current problem, this problem is without square root, and that's why answer is either 1 upon a or 1 upon 2a. Here minus sign indicates answer is 1 upon 2a. Log of format is there. 1 upon 2a, it is 1 upon 2, a is here, 3, into log of, you have to write this format. Firstly x plus 2, then 3, here is again x plus 2 and then 3. Here start with variable, so minus first, plus later on, and that's why answer is 1 upon 6, it is a log of x minus 1 upon x plus 5 and then plus c. Still we have solved 10 problems on this special integral. Present lecture will spend on just special integrals. Remaining problems will solve in that next lecture actually. Now take 11th one. This integration of 1 upon 7 plus 6x minus x square and in that dx. Now in order to solve this problem, here 6 is coefficient, x square, coefficient of x square is minus 1, it is allowed. Plus 1 and minus 1, these coefficients are allowed, not necessary to take common. If coefficient of x square is 7 suppose here, then that we have to take common. But when coefficient of x square is plus 1 or minus 1, it is allowed, it is not necessary to take common. Actually here is 6, make a half of this one. If we make half, 2 3's are 6, it is a 3 square, it is 9. So which term is added, which term is subtracted? Here is 7, so add 9, subtract 9, plus 6x minus x square and in that dx. These 2 terms and these 3 terms will separate. Now it is 1 upon 7 plus 9, it is 16. If you take minus common, I want perfect quadratic formation. Can I write this as x square? Minus common, that's why it is x square. Here minus common means it is minus 6x, and here minus common means it is plus 9. I want perfect squaring. Now 4 square, it is 16, minus, it is a perfect square of x minus 3 and in that dx. Once again recall that original special integrals, these are with square root or without square root. I think in this integrand there is no square root. My answer, it is in 1 by a or 1 by 2a. Minus sign indicates answer is in 1 by 2a form. So we have to write 1 by 2a, it is log of that portion, 4x minus 3, 4x plus 3 and in that plus c. A means this constant term 4, here is minus, here is plus. Simplify now. It is 1 8th of log of 4 minus x plus 3, and denominator is 4 plus x plus 3 and in c. I think it is x minus 3 also. So it should be x minus 3. It is 1 8th of, it is a log of, what is numerator? 7 minus x, and what is denominator? 4 minus 3 is 1 and plus x and in that plus c. Whatever I have written on the board, it is your next special integral case where x square is taken as negative. When coefficient is negative, then we have to write minus, that is 1 upon 2a. Take common when it is not minus 1 and not plus 1, then we have to take common. We will take problem of that matter also. Suppose in 12th one, it is 1 upon root of x square plus 4x plus 29 and in that tx. Now, in order to solve this problem, firstly, observe the coefficient of x square. What is the coefficient of x square? Coefficient of x square is 1. Which two coefficients are allowed? Plus 1 and minus 1. X square coefficient is 1, so it is allowed. Don't take common now. Just adjust with add and subtract. 1 upon x square plus 4x plus add 4, subtract 4, plus 29, and in that dx. Now, these three terms and these two terms. So it is integration of 1 upon square root of, it is a perfect square of x plus 2 plus 25 and in dx. I want again perfect square root. It is a perfect square root of x plus 2 and in pi square and in that dx. Problem is with square root or without square root, clear cut. This problem is with square root. Here coefficient of x square is positive, so answer is in log form and it is a finish. It is the log of variable term plus square root and plus c. What is the variable term? X plus 2, and what should be written here? X plus 2 whole square and plus 4 square or 5 square? 5 square. So simplify here. Log of x plus 2 plus, if we simplify this, I think this one, it is modified in that format. So if we simplify, we get directly that one. X square plus 4x plus 20. 9. It is your next problem from special integral case. Here all problems I will take now, it is in square root. Up to this one we have taken few problems from without square root, but we will take problem with square root now. Question number 13. Now if you take that question number 13, here it is. Integration of 1 upon square root of x square minus 8x minus 20 and in that dx. Now in present problem, it is also beneficial, x square coefficient is 1, so not needful to take common, just add and subtract. Now it is 1 upon square root of, which term is added, you have to observe now, it is minus 8x. What is half of 8? Half of 8 is 4. 4 square is 16, so add 16, subtract 16, minus 20 and in that dx. So it is equal to integration of 1 upon square root of, it is a perfect square of x minus 4 minus 36 and in that dx. Make a perfect square. It is a perfect square of x minus 4 minus 6 square and in that dx. Now we have to observe like this. Here problem is with square root, so answer is either log or sine inverse. X square coefficient is positive, so answer is clear cut in log. Where it is negative, then it is sine inverse. Otherwise it is just log of variable term plus square root and plus c. What is variable term? X minus 4, and we have to write here that same quantity, x minus 4 square plus, sorry, minus 6 square. So we are getting here log of x minus 4 plus square root of, same modified step here, it is x square minus 8x minus 20 and in that plus c. It is your required answer for this special integral next form. Now we will take example number 14. Next example we will take from special integrals here. Question number 14, it is somewhat big problem. In that one we have to take common from this one. Question number 14, it is integration of 1 upon 2x square plus 3x plus 5. 2x square plus 3x plus 5 and in that dx. Just remember this one. Coefficient of x square is here 2, and that one is not plus or minus 1. When plus and minus 1 is there, it is allowed, but here it is coefficient 2, so it is not allowed. So it is prime duty to take common here. You have to take common 2 from square root now. Take 2 common, you get x square plus 3 by 2x plus 5 by 2 and in that dx. 1 upon root 2 we have to take outside. Integration 1 upon square root of x square plus 3 by 2x and plus 5 by 2 and in that dx. Now x square coefficient is positive, it is allowed, just add and subtract. Now here it is 3 by 2, make a half of this one, and in square it is 9 by 36 or I think 16. 1 3 is a 3 square is 9, 2 2s are 4, 4 square is 16. So this quantity is added and subtracted. Now here it is 1 upon root 2 into square root into integration of 1 upon square root of x square plus 3 by 2 x plus, that term is added, 9 by 16 added, 9 by 16 subtracted, and plus 5 by 2, and in that dx. We'll write these three terms separate, these two terms separate. Proceed now. It is 1 upon root 3. It is integration of 1 upon root of. It is a perfect square of x plus 3 by 4. It is a plus. I will take LCM of these two denominators now. What is LCM of these two denominators? It is 16. Now it is a routine procedure from primary level. 16 divided by 16, it is 1. And 1 multiplied by minus 9, it is minus 9. Plus 16 divided by 2 is 8. 8 5 is 40. You have to write like this. It is 1 upon root 3. Integration of 1 upon square root of. It is x plus 3 by 4 whole square. Plus 31 upon 16. And in that dx. Now take make a perfect square, variable term square plus constant term square. Now variable term square and constant term square, if you continue here, 1 upon root 3, it is 1 upon root of, it is x plus 3 by 4 whole square, plus it is a root 31 by 4 whole square, and in that dx. Now we have to observe the special integral case. Now this problem is with square root, so green signal, answer is either log or sine inverse. When coefficient of x square is positive, answer is strictly log. So we have to write 1 by root 3 log. What should be format here? Variable term plus square root and plus c. Variable term here it is x plus 3 by 4, and this square root term is x plus 3 by 4 whole square plus root 31 by 4 whole square. Just continue. 1 by root 3 log of, it is x plus 3 by 4 plus square root. If we simplify, x square means we have to write the term with x square. X square plus 3 by 2 x plus 5 by 2. Simplify and get the answer, and then that plus c, it is your required answer. So take one next. I think it is 14, it is 15 now. Integration of 1 upon square root of 21 plus 4x minus x square, and in that dx. I think we have to observe the coefficient of x square here. What is the coefficient of x square? Minus 1. Which two coefficients are allowed? Plus 1 and minus 1. Here is minus 1, so this coefficient is allowed. Just add and subtract. Now observe that main situation of add and subtract here. Here is coefficient 4. So what is half of 4? 2. 2 square is 4. So add 4, subtract 4. 21 is as it is. Add 4, subtract 4. And that routine. Plus 4x minus x square, and in that dx. These two terms separate, these three terms separate. So it is integration of 1 upon square root of 21 plus 4. It is 25. If we reverse this situation, it is x square minus 4x plus 4, and in that dx. I want perfect squares. It is 1 upon square root of, it is a 5 square minus x minus 2 square, and in that dx. Now it is first time happens in this listing now. In that 15 list here, very first time it is a coefficient of x square is negative, and that's why answer is in sine inverse. Answer is in sine inverse of x by a. X by a means x minus 2 upon 5, and in that plus c. Now in next problem we'll continue here. Example number 16, that is. In that one 16, it is integration of 1 upon square root of 1 minus x square into 9 plus sine inverse x bracket square, and in that tx. I think this problem is very simple. Inverse trigonometric functions are big indicators for method of solution. Put the sine inverse x equal to 2 and get the answer. Here we'll take lid capital I equal to integration of 1 upon square root of 1 minus x square. In the second bracket it is 9 plus sine inverse x bracket square and in that dx. Now sine inverse, it is a method of substitution, so put sine inverse x equal to t. What is derivative of sine inverse? It is 1 upon root of 1 minus x square dx and it is equal to what? Dt. So this 1 upon root and dx, 1 upon root and dx both gives dt here. So it is capital I, it is equal to dt upon, this is 9 and this becomes here t square. So it is a special integral case of 3 square plus t square. Observe the case now. How many special integrals we are having? I think these are 6 special integrals. 3 are without square root, 3 are with square root. This is without square root and here sine is plus. So answer is 1 upon a tan inverse of variable term upon constant plus c. So it is 1 upon a means 3. Variable term is t, constant term is 3. So 1 upon 3 tan inverse of. What is that t here? T is replaced by sine inverse x upon 3 and plus c. It is your final answer for that problem number 16 actually. Now we'll take next one problem, that is example number 17. Here it is integration 1 upon x raised to 2 by 3 into square root of x raised to 2 by 3 minus 4 and in that tx. In current problem, we'll take given problem as capital I. Let capital I equal to integration of 1 upon square, 1 upon x raised to 2 by 3 into square root of x raised to 2 by 3 minus 4 and in that tx. We'll rub this matter here only. Now we'll take this fresh problem here now. Now in this one, basic technique of this special integral is, this is a perfect square and this should be perfect square. Firstly, make a perfect square here. I will write in numerator now x raised to minus 2 by 3 upon square root of, it is a perfect square of x raised to 1 by 3 and it is a perfect square of 2 and in that dx. I think this is a perfect square, this is your perfect square. Now this inner quantity bracket, it is a big indicator for method of substitution. Put that as t and get the answer. Put x raised to 1 by 3 is equal to t. Power shift and then get the answer. Power shift means 1 by 3, x raised to 1 by 3 minus 1 dx and is equal to dt. So 1 by 3, x raised to, if we make subtraction of this 1 by 3 and minus 1, it becomes minus 2 by 3 dx and is equal to dt. Now just observe, we want which quantity? We want x raised to minus 2 by 3 dx. Now write this one, x raised to minus 2 by 3 dx, this divisor 3 becomes here multiplier and that is here 3 dt. So capital I becomes, numerator is dt upon square root of dt or 3 dt, I think it is 3 dt, x raised to minus 2 by 3 dx, that is here 3 dt upon, this quantity is here x raised to 1 by 3, this quantity is here t, so it is a t square minus 2 square, t square minus 2 square. In this integrand, 3 is pure constant, I think. You have to take outside. Now take that 3 as outside term. It is a dt upon square root of t square minus 2 square. Now this problem is with square root, so it has two answers. Either it is a log or it is sine inverse. But this is t square coefficient is positive, so answer is clear cut log. So it is a 3 times log of, it is a t plus square root of t square minus 2 square and plus c. So it is a 3 times log of t square, t is what is the value of t here, x raised to 1 by 3 plus t square means x raised to 2 by 3 and 2 square means 4 and in that plus c. It is your required answer. We have completed 17 problems in this present list. Coming to example number 18 now. This is important for board and CET also. Here it is e raised to x by 2 upon root of a square e raised to x. A square e raised to x plus b square e raised to minus x and in that dx. Just observe here. Let capital I equal to integration e raised to x by 2 upon root of a square e raised to x plus b square e raised to minus x and in that dx. Now take a fresh problem I have written on the board. It is example number 18 now. Now in this one, here it is e raised to minus x. Can I write this e raised to minus x as 1 upon e raised to x? And if it is right one, then I can write like this e raised to x by 2 upon square root of a square e raised to x plus b square upon e raised to x and in that dx. Now take LCM and proceed. Here it is e raised to x by 2 upon square root of a square, it is e raised to x LCM. So it is a square e raised to x whole square and plus b square and in that dx. Now e raised to x by 2, I can write this as root of e raised to x divided by root upon root, this main denominator portion and in that dx. What is written as a numerator here? A square e raised to x bracket square plus b square and upon root of e raised to x. Now this is the main denominator line. If we make into, then this quantity becomes reciprocate. Right here, reciprocal of this denominator quantity. Now what should be written here? It is root of e raised to x into root of e raised to x and total divided by root of a square into e raised to x bracket square plus b square and in that dx. Now you are knowing root of e raised to x into root of e raised to x. It is simply e raised to x upon root of a square e raised to x bracket square and plus b square and in that dx. Just if you observe, you are 100% knowing what is derivative of e raised to x. This is e raised to x, so clear cut put now. Put this e raised to x equal to t. What is derivative of e raised to x? E raised to x dx, it is equal to dt. So replace and get the answer now. This e raised to x and this e raised to x dx, it is what? Dt. So I equal to integration of dt upon square root of, here it is a square t square plus b square. So it is a dt upon square root of a t whole square plus b square. Dt is already written. Now this problem is with square root. This discussion we will make later on, but here t coefficient is a and that's why we have to write very firstly it is 1 upon e. Now make a discussion. This problem is with square root. When it is with square root, then coefficient of t square is positive, so we have to write the answer compulsory in log. Now log of a t plus square root of, it is a square t square and plus b square and in that plus c. So your next here it is 1 upon a log of a. What is value of t now? E raised to x plus square root of a square e raised to 2x plus b square and plus c. We have written that t square is replaced by e raised to 2x. Just we'll stop here only.